At the time of this video's release, the sun is now rising in the Netherlands on March 17th to a nation that is set to go to the polls and cast their votes for members of the House of Representatives after the dissolution of Prime Minister Rutte's third cabinet. They have a clear option before them, to preserve their nation and see it brought back to glory, or to continue moving it along the pathway to destruction. Make no mistake, there is ultimately only one man, one party, and one vision that is capable of preserving Dutch civilization. Mr. Baudet, Americans may not know of your party, but they know of your struggle. The struggle for national renewal is one that unites every one of us fortunate enough to live on the ground where the light of Western civilization shines its rays. We are all men struggling to start up a vehicle on the side of the road on an icy northern winter night, praying that we feel the warmth of the radiator before we feel the icy chill of a hypothermic death. In our vehicles lie our families, our friends, those most precious to us in the whole world, and if we fail, they will also suffer the consequences. Those vehicles are our nations, and despite never setting foot in the Netherlands, not speaking a word of its people's language, and not having Dutch blood flowing through my veins, I know its beauty. The harbors of Amsterdam are the harbors from which men like Hudson, Barents, and Tasman set out to make their mark upon the world, and now their names mark maps from the Hudson River to Tasmania, remnants of your people's mark upon the world. Never forget that New York City was originally New Amsterdam, and Australia, New Holland. To those same harbors came ships of the Dutch East India Company, their holds packed with nutmeg, mace, cloves, and coffee from the East Indies, goods that would turn your nation into the richest the world has ever known. Your ancestors settled Manhattan, Batavia, Taiwan, and the South African Cape. They landed in Australia and New Zealand, and your cousins, the Afrikaners, have fought for their existence since they first arrived on the Dark Continent. Mr. Baudet, when I first heard of your improbable victories in 2019, I was inspired. I felt hope for the first time in a while, not just for the Netherlands, but for Western society as a whole. I watched every interview I could find of you in English, and I felt I could sleep easy knowing men like you were fighting on my side for the preservation of everything that we hold so dear. If my nation had a man like you, I would not fear for its future. If every nation that makes up our boreal world had a man like you, I would not fear for their future. You are the forum for democracy, and you are hope for the Dutch people and for people like myself who watch your fight from outside of your borders. If saving our nation from destruction was easy, then it would have already been done. It will get rough. The forces complicit in our destruction will slander you, set the dogs on you, do everything in their power to see you ostracized from civil society. But you know that. You've experienced it. You've also seen what happens when that doesn't work. Pim-410's murder showed you that. There's no quitting. You see it through because our enemies will not let you merely go back to what you were before you made the outrageous decision to move against them and their broken system. They will not settle for detente, only your destruction. If you ever cease in your journey, they will bury you for good. Truthfully, the fall you've taken ultimately isn't as bad as it seems. We fall so we can learn to pick ourselves up again. It was never going to be so easy as taking power in the span of 5 years. Frankly, that isn't even necessary. When you hit rock bottom, and people feel like they have nothing left to gain from you, they reveal their true colors. Your betrayal at the hands of Vollard Dingerbroek and Eichmans should serve as a blessing in disguise, for they would have betrayed you later on anyhow, and even honest enemies are superior to dishonest friends. The opportunists revealed themselves, and you have a clean slate moving forward. Mr. Baudet, just as our General Eisenhower said in June of 1944 to the troops stepping onto the beaches at Normandy, the hope and prayers of liberty-loving people march with you, whether they know it or not. For your struggle is our struggle. No matter what happens tonight, know this, we will know victory in the end. Our cause is just, our anger righteous. After this day, we will have a better idea of where to go going forward. But no matter what happens, there is reason to be optimistic, for in Baudet, the Netherlands has their champion, something not true of Wilders or even 410 before him. Baudet is the only one capable of saving the Netherlands. His party, the only one who stands against lockdowns, the only one that stands against university indoctrination, the only one that stands against journalist subversion, and the only ones against the corruption of the elites. Baudet has political solutions to the problems of the Dutch people, where Wilders is empty words and rhetoric. Baudet is committed to saving his country, Wilders is committed to remaining in opposition in perpetuity. The Netherlands is not yet lost, but if action is not yet taken, it may be one day. Every member of Dutch society that calls themselves a patriot, who cherishes their culture and loves their family, must awaken from their hibernation and come to stand with the Forum for Democracy, the bulwark against the destruction of everything they hold near and dear.